Okay, so this was really hard because I had to mount the motor and get the ESC up in the front because that was the only way that it would balance at the CG. And so as you can see, it's tail heavy right now because there's no battery. But what I did is I actually tucked the ESC up here, and then I actually moved the holes down here for the barbecue skewers down so that I had room up there to put the ESC. And the ESC like tucks nicely behind this little slab of foam right here. This is actually just a little piece of foam in the front to stop the power pod, but there's actually just air behind it. So the ESC is tucked up there, and then the motor is right here. I was able to run the battery lead right here. And so the battery will just be able to sit on the power pod with Velcro and plug into this lead right here. So I have this Velcro right here. It has sticky adhesive on both sides. So this is the soft side that I'm gonna put on the battery right here. So that's gonna sit right there. All right, so we're gonna weigh the plane. So I'm gonna set it down on the scale here, and all of the parts are isolated. And as you can see, it says 199 grams, so it's basically 200 grams. And that's actually lighter than I thought it was gonna be considering how heavy it felt in my hand, but I guess it's just dense because of the electronics. And then with the battery right here, we're getting about 239 grams. At the same time, the little bit of extra weight is gonna work out in the end because this motor is a 2206 motor and it's recommended for like an 1806. And then the propeller is also 6 inches, but the recommended is 5 inches. So even though it's a little bit heavier than usual, we'll have more power. So hopefully it ends up working out. All right, so I don't know how well this is gonna work, but I have this hat cam here. So I'm gonna turn the radio on and plug the plane in. All right, so let's make sure all the control surfaces are working first. So left, right, up and down. Okay, I'm gonna give it some up elevator. Okay, I'm just gonna launch it and see what happens. Hopefully I can like control it. We'll just see. Whoa. I don't know what that was. Oh, the battery adhesive tape came off, probably because of the cold. Propeller is completely fine, surprisingly. So I'm just gonna stuff all the wires in here. Oh, there we go. Okay, it's flying. All right, we're flying. It's stalling out. I just hit that tree. Okay, here's the battery. Battery's still good. Let me just blow some snow off. Oh, there goes the propeller. And the prop nut is in the snow. So here's the prop nut in the snow here. And propeller just flew this way. So that did work. I'm gonna go assess the situation and then take it back out for another flight, whether that's today or tomorrow. So let's go. All right, so it snowed again, but I'm gonna try flying this again. So there was damage to the wing right here, but I just repaired it, so everything's fine now. And there was right here too. The wing kind of ripped in half partially, but I just glued it and now it's good as new. All right, there's kind of some wind, so we'll see what happens. I'm gonna put, all right, I'm just gonna go. Okay. It's going. It's still very pitchy.
Okay, at least it had a soft landing. So I think the elevator was way too pitchy, but the rudder felt fine. So I'm gonna try normal rates again. All right. Oh, I just stalled out. Okay, there we go. Okay, it's flying. No, don't stall. There is a lot of wind. But it's flying. It's flying pretty good considering that there's a lot of wind. Oh, the wind. But it's going. The wind's just making it go really fast. There's a loop by accident. But it's actually working. It's pretty cool. This is gonna definitely help with my flight time experience here, as I can fly in my yard. Whoa. Oh, and right into the snow. All right, I just tried to warm my hands, so we're gonna take this up again, and then we'll end the video. Oh, it's hovering. Oh, that's not good. I just broke a whole wing off. All right, let's unplug this here. Well, there is a FT Mini Scout in half. Yeah, so that's gonna probably end it for this video. What I'll do is I'll fix this and then we'll take it back in a future video and fly it. So overall, it's still a really fun project, a little bit difficult in the cold, but we still kind of completed it. So thanks for watching this video and I'll see you in the next one. Okay, so I actually fixed the wing instead of doing it in another video because it is really easy. So here's the wing. There's a lot of wind, so I don't even know if it's good.